Hey there, Joomla fans. Tim Davis here. I'm a Joomla fan too. Thanks for tuning in to the first of a new series of live streams that I'm going to be having on Mondays. Let me just turn the sound off there. Maintenance Mondays. We're going to take a look each Monday at a little thing that we can do to maintain our Joomla sites. Might be get rid of files we don't need, organize the file structure properly, shrink down the size of the whole Joomla install itself if things get left on there that don't need to be. Anyways, we'll be looking at lots of things. If you want to be updated when the new live streams or new tutorials land on the channel, then by all means, please subscribe and ring that notifications bell so you get those notifications. And so let's take a look at things now here today. I'm going to be taking a lot of this information from the audit information from my Joomla sites that I get from MyJoomla.com. That's Phil Taylor's website that you can use for maintaining and also updating your Joomla sites. I've been using it for a little while now, and it's got tons of helpful information. The thing I really like about Phil's site is that not only does it have recommendations or find things or suggest things, but there's a lot of really good learning material on there. So I've been picking up a lot of information on maintaining my Joomla sites or maintaining Joomla sites in general. Anyways, now I do want you to know, for those of you already have subscribed and are getting updates and watching things, every month we're giving away a free one-year membership to maintain one Joomla site on myjoomla.com, Phil Taylor's site. So you'll find links to enter that contest down below. You could just go to the basicjoomla.com website and go click on contests, and this contest will be at the top. And today it's the last day of July, so we'll be picking a winner for this month before we start next month's contest. Now, if you haven't used Phil's site and got an audit for your website, you can get a free audit. And again, I'll have the links down below and probably in a card here. You'll get information from a snapshot of your site and also from an audit that's done on your site. And that audit isn't just an external scan, it's an internal look at all of the files on your install. And then you'll get recommendations and ideas and warnings and various things. And today, what I thought we'd focus on is this one particular one here. Let me just find it, and I should switch to my grandpa computer glasses here, is the location of, here we go, Joomla Logs temp folder location should exist at default locations. Now, I've had a little bit of confusion about this over the years, like especially for the log folder for Joomla. Should it be /log or /logs? And was able to come to a definitive answer here from the reading up on the information. And just to show you here, I click learn more, read up, that it should be logs plural. Now there are some cases where people programming extensions or other things may use log, but it's important for our Joomla sites to be set up with the defaults in place so that when extensions that are set up correctly are looking for the temp folder or the log folder, that they find it in the right location. And it's just an easier way to find your error file. So somehow along the way, a lot of my sites have ended up with log. And if you get a free audit, you can read more about that and other things on your site here. Now, the fix for this is to log into the back end of your Joomla site, which I've already done here on the basicjoomla.com site. Go to System, Global Configuration. And the first thing we're going to check is the System tab. And here we see the path to the log folder. Home, Basic Joo, which is the unfortunate, after I'd already created this, the unfortunate name of eight-character name of the web hosting account on my server for Basic Joomla, the public HTML folder, and then log. Log and temp reside in the root folder of the Joomla install. And this should be logs. Now, to change it, it's as easy as adding an S to the end, and we'll just click save. Now, having saved that, I have opened up in my file manager for this web hosting account the root folder. I'm just going to refresh it now, having created that logs folder. And you'll see that here I still only have log. Logs is not automatically created once you change the address of the path here in the Joomla configuration. Now, I did do some other testing though, and I found that if I try to log into the back end of my website with an incorrect password, it registered that area and it created the logs folder. So you don't necessarily need to create the logs folder in your hosting account. It will be automatically created by Joomla. But I also wonder if maybe every system that wants to access that, if maybe it won't happen the same way. And I could be wrong. Maybe as soon as any extension tries to write to logs, if it doesn't exist, maybe Joomla makes it. I don't know. The solution to be safe is to simply, when you're in the root, in your file manager, just create that folder. And I'll do that right now. I'm going to create that folder, L-O-G-S. And there, now I've got it, logs. But I still have this old log folder. Don't need it anymore. It's become clutter because it's the wrong location. What I would suggest is, first of all, go into your old log file, if this is a situation you're facing, and see if there's any error files that maybe have some information for what you're looking for. Now, if you find, no, there's really no error files in there that I'm really concerned about, or maybe even notice that they're getting large and you're not going to bother reading them, you want to start over fresh, then what I would do is just go back up to the root, select log, and I'm just going to delete that. And now I know that I have logs in the proper location. We can click back here to the global configuration, and now we want to just double check on temp. And when I click on server, I see TMP, temp, it's in the right location and it's spelled correctly. So this doesn't say temps, it's not T-E-M-P, it's TMP. And so I know that everything is good and I've maintained that part of my Joomla site, and that's one less thing. And the great thing is I'll have that feeling of satisfaction the next time my Joomla takes a snapshot of the site, and it will fix that warning and show that it's changed. And there is a tip for Maintenance Monday on how to maintain your Joomla site. So I'll wrap that up now before I look to see if there's anyone in the live chat. Thank you very much for watching, as always, and for joining me on this journey, getting more enjoyment and success out of our Joomla sites. Please subscribe, ring that notification bell so you get constantly updated when new things come out to help you with your Joomla site. And so, as always, enjoy your Joomla sites, and God bless.